How's it going, guys? And welcome to our coverage of Blade Show 2019. I'm sitting down with Hank from Wii, and he's going to run us through a bunch of new stuff that Wii has coming out, and that some stuff that just was recently released, right?
Recently.
So yeah, so hold on, it's going to be some really rad stuff. Thanks
some
for being here.
Some are actually debuting.
Yeah, debuting right now, exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so what do we got first?
First of all, we got the Synergy. The Synergy is a design of Jim O'Jong, a collaboration with Jim O'Jong, and we have it released in several variations, Tento and Trailing Point, and then both in several variations, different anodizations, with or without carbon fiber inlay. This is, for example, a marbled anodization. Mm-hmm. This is a plain gray anodization with very subtle milling work. This is with the carbon fiber, and then so we have six variations in total. Let me show it again for the camera. And then we have a lot of history behind this knife. This is debuting now, right now in 2019 during Blade Show, and in 1999, the original Synergy debuted and won the most innovative American design award.
Wow, so 20 years ago.
Exactly 20
same,
years ago.
The same design, that's amazing.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And Jim, the designer, hooked up with us last year.
Yeah.
And he told about his design, and Joe, my boss, was very excited. And so the Synergy is there right
that's
now.
Great.
And we got a lot of attention at the booth right now. A lot of people were interested. It's kind of a hype.
Yeah, no, so, it's a really neat knife. And what's the blade steel on this?
M390.
Yes, so and I don't know if you guys at home can see, but hopefully you can, but the milling here, you said it's a subtle milling, it also works as a really nice grip. It feels great in hand.
The way the milling is done, it almost acts like microfiber grip.
Yeah, it kind of just grabs right to your hand. So, really, really great design.
Yeah.
You know, but this is exactly what we expect from Wii.
Yeah.
We love Wii knives. You guys do an amazing job. So this is awesome to see this.
And I forgot to mention, it's a full titanium integral. So a full titanium body milled out of one piece. Okay, what's next? I'm very excited with a new Civivi design. It's called the Duris. It's debuting right now during Blade Show, so it will be available for the dealers, Blade HQ, after the show. This is a very nice, capable, sturdy, hand-filling model. So not a big knife, but really you got something in hand.
Yeah, which is saying a lot, because you have, so I have kind of a medium hand, but you have a larger hand.
Yeah,
yeah.
And it really fills my hand. Without, so it's a three-finger knife for me,
mm-hmm.
but not with sharp angles or with whatever can hurt you. It really has great ergos. And we have it available in several colors, like orange, like blue, like black. This is the gray with a brown variation, but also, and that's very nice, with the Chinese Damascus. So it's also attractive, appealing, like a pocket jewelry.
Yeah, a little bit of pocket jewelry, but in the Civivi line still.
And then the MSRP on the Damascus variety, I don't know exactly, but I think it was something like $95 MSRP.
MSRP.
For the Damascus variety.
So as you guys know on the website, you know, that pricing varies. So check out Blade HQ and figure out what that exact pricing is. But that's pretty cool with the Damascus blade.
Yeah.
You know,
So I'm very excited about this one. I think it really is a valuable addition to the Civivi lineup.
Yeah, no, I agree. And, you know, when you say hand filling, it really is. I mean, for me, a medium sized hand, that's a four finger knife, right?
Yeah.
And you've got a lot in hand.
Yeah. Yeah, you have a real good purchase.
And then profile wise, like you said, just it's a nice knife. It's not too chunky. Right, because
exactly.
Sometimes you get those smaller knives and they're just too chunky.
Yeah.
This is right on the right level.
Yeah.
And again, I mean, whether it's Wii or Civivi, whatever the name is, Civivi always does a great job.
Yeah. I'm very happy with the Civivi lineup.
Yeah.
I think we really serve a lot of people.
It's been a great addition in that price point for sure.
Yeah. Next up, we released it last month. This is an integral full-sized integral, so milled out of one piece of titanium, and it's a more Quaken stylish tactical knife, and this is called the Syngro. It has a full 4-inch blade, M390 blade steel, and a lot of people, this will appeal to a lot of people who like the more slim, slender tactical designs.
Yeah.
So it's really hand filling, but despite it is an integral, it has a lot of milling on the inside, though, so it is not that heavy for an integral.
Yep.
Most of the times, integrals tend to be very heavy.
Yep.
This one doesn't. For a 9-inch blade, this is not heavy at all. You can feel it yourself.
Yeah, we've had these at HQ, and you're right, they're not heavy at all for what you're getting.
Yep.
And you know, and I like the profile of the knife when it's open. For me personally, for my EDC, I'm not a big fan of a larger knife, but one thing that I love about this knife is I love the way it looks closed.
Yeah, the profile.
The profile on this thing is just amazing, right? Yeah. Like, it's just a beautiful knife.
Yeah.
So, great design all the way around. An M390 blade, right?
M390
blade. Yes, I'm pretty sure you said that. So.
Okay, then next up, and I think this will be appreciated by a lot of people who want a no-nonsense, high-end, small EDC-able knife, which is also suitable for an office environment or when going to church or when going to a wedding. This is the Schism. It's a very utilitarian blade shape, but it's very capable for general EDC tasks. No nonsense blade and with a lot of milling, so it's very light. I don't memorize the exact weight, but I think it's around 3 ounces.
It's a lighter knife, but again, well balanced.
Well balanced.
The blade doesn't.
Exactly.
Because that's the other thing is you'll get with a knife that has a lot of milling.
Yeah.
Sometimes that handle comes too light, and then the blade's blade heavy, right?
Yeah. Exactly.
But this has got a nice balance.
Very
to it.
Nice balance. And it's really very thin behind the edge. It has a hollow grind, so this will slice.
Great slicer.
And for most people, this is legal to carry. In I think all states of the United States because of the 3-inch, I think it's 3-inch blade.
Yeah, always check your local laws too, but a good chance that it's legal where you're at.
Yeah.
And as you guys know, if you watched the last Week 1 Wednesday that we did, we actually just gave one of these away to one of the lucky viewers.
Okay.
So we really like this knife, and that's why we gave it away to you guys, is we got these a couple weeks ago, and we've really been digging them.
Yeah, this is a very nice knife. So, the Schism.
Yeah.
Next up, a lot of people will like it, the Elijah Isham designs.
Oh, he's like a new designer, right?
Exactly.
No, we love Elijah Isham stuff.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Even, you know, the more fantastical things to the more practical, everything Elijah does is awesome.
And I really wanted to bring a McKenna, his latest design, but unfortunately, we had a few available and they were all sold this morning. And the McKenna is really a very fun front flipper design.
Yep.
It's the size of the Schism, maybe even smaller.
Yeah.
Shorter. But unfortunately, so you have to do another video on that.
Well, don't worry, guys. As soon as we get some in, we'll make sure you see them.
Yeah. But I can show you the Anthropos. It's also a front flipper. With a carbon fiber laminate. This is the Chinese Damascus variant. So we have a lot of varieties with different G10 and carbon fiber laminate. But this is the Damascus variety. And it's a very nice draw point design. It's not too large, it's very light. I think this is a 3.25 inch blade. And a lot of people will like this design.
Yeah.
So it has a good action. It is a liner lock. The front flipper works really very well.
Yeah.
And you barely notice the flipper tab. It's now, very small.
Now I might be, so not front flipper though, right? Because there's not a flipper here.
No, yeah.
So just flipper, right?
It is a flipper,
okay.
But because of the location, you could call it a front flipper.
Oh, okay, I see what you're saying. All right. Yeah.
But it's actually a real flipper.
Yeah, like a flipper flipper. Yeah. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I was looking at it, I was like, front flipper?
And this one is another variety. This is with the Chinese D2 steel.
Mm-hmm.
So exactly the same knife, but with Chinese D2 steel. So check out the varieties on the Anthropos.
And I can't remember, does this also come in multiple colors?
Yes,
it does, right? Yeah, yeah, it has multiple colors.
Yeah.
That's one thing that Civivi does really well is it's a solid design, and then you can get it kind of dressed up in whatever color you prefer, which is nice.
And then next up, the Pleteros. Pleteros, I don't know how to pronounce it. It's difficult with Elijah's names.
Yeah.
But also the flipper tab, very small flipper tab hidden. It is very similar to the Anthropos, but there is also some distinguishing differences.
Yeah,
as you
get
can see.
A little bit of a bigger blade there. Obviously, the handle shape is going to be a little bit different.
Yep. Exactly. But then it's a matter of personal taste. Mm-hmm. Which one do you prefer?
Yeah.
And if you don't be if you aren't able to make a choice, then you take both.
Yeah, you can get both because it's a Civivi.
It's a Civivi.
Exactly.
The budget.
Chances are you can afford
affordable.
Both. Yeah, exactly.
So, and this one has also a very more forward grip, but a very good purchase. You can try it.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And I like to have, especially with a knife like this, I like to have jimping across here usually.
Mm-hmm.
But the way that the handle stops you here kind of in this rest, it feels really good in hand.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's a great little knife.
Okay, I think that covers all the new stuff.
Great, wonderful.
For now.
Well, thanks for being on. Appreciate
it. Thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Okay.
And thank you guys for watching. Make sure to check out our 2019 Blade Show playlist here on YouTube. And we'll see you on the next one.